met with Laing O'Rourke in about September-ish time, talking about how they could support our pupils. I feel like pupils have missed out on so much because of the pandemic, like visits out of school and links with employers, and you know, a lot of what they've done is just schoolwork online. So I really wanted to do something a bit different this year.
We are the contractor building Abraham Moss Library and Leisure Centre. So a huge part of our role whilst we're working in communities is around leaving a positive lasting legacy and providing learning opportunities for local people, and to showcase some of the opportunities within the industry.
So all these pupils have applied to do this work experience in their holidays, so it's done in their own time.
My role in this project is it's project director for Ellis Williams Architects. My role really is very, very early on in the project, where I'd be involved in sort of bringing the work in, agreeing the appointments and contracts, that sort of thing. I think as you get older and further through your career, you become a lot more conscious about how important the next generation of architects or engineers or whatever it is, how important that is.
Kind of running order for the 3 days is that it's quite fast paced, so the students over the 3 days have got to come up with their own Our Leisure Hub idea, so loosely based on what they're learning about the Abraham Moss Library and Leisure Centre. They're getting insight to industry professionals that are working on the scheme, from the architecture consultants to the design team consultants.
Main aim is for community to have a place where they can, you know, entertain themselves as well as strengthen their community relationship.
We are creating a new design for the once was known as the Abraham Moss Leisure Centre. We are enhancing it further now, creating one of the best facilities in Manchester for leisure and gym activities.
It was just nice to come and speak to some of the younger generations now, who are maybe not just interested in architecture but the whole of construction. Just to come and just show them what we do, and maybe it'll spark an interest.
I think if we're going to create a society where it's more equally split with women, and women need to get involved in the process of building the structures, get involved in building the societies in which we live in, if we're going to make it more of an equal balance.
I did all my study in France, so went to university in France, and after that I found a job, internship first in London, and moved to UK. And this is how I started my career.
We're finalising our presentation and adding our finishing touches. We're currently doing our exterior design and showing how it will look like from the outside. We've also used foam boards to gather all of our ideas together and present them. And it shows our development of our sketches to our final design.
I find that engineering is a creative medium which uses unique designs and solutions, but within limitations, so you can consider new adaptions and new ways of working, but it has to be set within scientific barriers, and I like that limitation within engineering.
GLL offer a range of schemes in traineeships and apprenticeships and management schemes that help pupils leaving school and going into college and gain real life on the job experience in our industry.
It's quite challenging because you need to take into consideration that it doesn't break, it holds in place, and it needs to be really tall as well. You've got a limited amount of resources, and it's good teamwork.
Teamwork makes the dream work, basically.
This afternoon they will be presenting to the council, Manchester City Council, who obviously are involved in the leisure centre.
I thought today was really impressive in how much detail the children took on, particularly as they haven't had any formal training. It was really, really impressive.